This is an opportunity, I thought, to preserve something in perpetuity for everybody to get some benefit from. And besides, it's kind of nice to keep a bit of nature and a bit of natural habitat in a fast-growing area like ours. So it's obviously a great opportunity to set it aside. It can't be developed and will stay this way for the rest of time. I was trained as a biologist, and obviously being a chair of the Environment Committee and being on the Environment Committee in Ottawa, trying to put forward a concept of conservation and inform information for people. So it's been part of my life for a long time. It's an opportunity to give this to future generations. This project basically will incorporate all of Slack Slough, which is about 100 acres, and then the land which we will donate south of the project, adjacent to it. There'll be a wildlife center, a center that will educate on water, aquifers, talk about the oil and gas industry changes, talk about some of the good things that the environment represents for us, and of course emphasizing the importance of water and wetlands. As our glaciers disappear and as the changes occur in the aquifers and so on in our area, obviously water is going to become a greater and greater concern. In fact, it could even slow down the development of our area. And so we've got to educate people on the importance of wetlands, of water, and of preserving it and limiting the waste of water that we have so common today. If you look at wetlands, basically they are the major feeder. They provide over 50% of the water for our rivers. So the glaciers are 50% and the aquifers, the wetlands are the other 50%. So obviously preserving that 50% then becomes critical, because that's something we really can control. We need to understand the importance of wetlands, the importance of preserving the water quality in our area, and the importance of maintaining the aquifers at the levels they are today. It's accessibility, because you can bring field trips from Red Deer here in sort of 15 minutes, and having Red Deer College with its alternate energy site, Olds College with its wetland site, obviously they can take advantage of it, and it has easy accessibility. And of course we'll have 120,000 people a day going past who can, in some way, whether it's a family outing, a seniors outing, will be able to utilize the facility. This will be a great opportunity to educate not only industry and farmers and industry, but to educate the general public on the importance of water and wetlands. Having Red Deer County as the one of the leads on this project, being able to have their environment department located in this building, gives it longevity. It means it can last. It means that it's not going to close down in 5 years' time because of lack of funding. It means it will be there as a permanent place and can develop its programs accordingly. So I think the importance of the Rotary Club, the citizens being involved, and the Red Deer County managing it and controlling it literally will be very important to its success. We've identified 96 species here, and there's probably more. There are a couple of endangered species here in terms of amphibians, and there's just any number of other potential opportunities here to educate people. It's close to Red Deer, at the entrance to the city of Red Deer and the county of Red Deer. What better message to send than, hey, we care about our environment? People will be able to come off the highway on their way to Edmonton or Calgary, and of course the citizens of Central Alberta will have easy access to it. There will be, over time, developed a trail system. It will be joining. There's going to be a green zone set up by the county between here and the Red Deer Trail system. So it will be an extension of the Red Deer Trail system to this site. There will be a building, hopefully, on the east side and of Slack Slough, and that building then will be where the education begins. Hopefully someday a hidden blind where people can actually get into it and the birds will act normal, and they'll be able to view them, and of course any other areas of the ecosystem that they want to look at. So what we need now is to get industry behind it, we need to get citizens behind it, and of course we need to convince the two levels of government, three levels of government really, that this is an important project and important for our long-term future to preserve an ecosystem.